Hey, good morning to you. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Good afternoon if you're watching this later in the day. I got a good tropical update for you guys, and not only is the Euro and the GFS both showing a major hurricane coming mostly to the southeast of the U.S., also I have the time frame that you need to think about of what we're going to be having soon for this hurricane season. It's about to ramp up. Now, if you've never been here before, hello, my name is Mark. I do upload every single day, just not Friday from sundown to Saturday from sundown, that's Sabbath. But make sure you hit that subscribe button because I am all year around. Matter of fact, I've been here almost 6 years. Now, when you look at the satellite this morning, you do see we have two good tropical waves coming off the coast of Africa. Now, this first one actually here, it has a big plume of dust that's going to be in front of it. And this one is actually going to take a little more southern track. This is going to go towards the east pack. Maybe a problem later coming out by Central America or the Bay of Campeche, and maybe being another issue later on. That's way down the road. But this wave coming off right here, this is the one we need to worry about. This is the one that sits in the time frame according to the Euro and the GFS. Matter of fact, I'm even showing this wave right here has a good potential to break off into two pieces. One that rides across the Northern Islands and one that just gets sucked around by the high pressure. So I'm going to go through everything I have for you. If you like this update, guys, hit that like button. Make sure you share this information. Alert people that our hurricane season has started. Matter of fact, both models, GFS and Euro, are both showing the same general area for a major hurricane. So we do have a lot of things we need to think about, a lot of things we need to prepare for. I hope you get prepared for this hurricane season because it's about to pop off. Now, when you look at our potential velocity anomaly to see when we might have some updraft, some vorticity going on in our area. And our area is West Coast 120 and East Coast 60W up by the islands. And we have this big mass, very strong system all the way from August 11th all the way to August 16th. And this is the time frame that the Euro and the GFS is showing a major hurricane. We go look all the way to August 12th, which is 10 days away, guys. This is exactly starting in about 9 to 10 days away. And you can see all the activity that's been in the south that's getting pushed to the southeast. That's from the video I showed you the last couple of days of what's going on with too high pressure squeezing. That's still happening. Now, according to the cyclone ensembles, we do have a strong potential that is pretty high in the Atlantic. And we have a couple things that's going towards the Caribbean, one a little lower. Exactly 10 days away. And when you go forward a little bit, you can see that this one right here that went a little higher starts making its way towards northern Atlantic. That's because its high pressure is going to start retracting back to northeast of the Atlantic, and it's going to leave all this open. But we have another cold front coming down, and this next cold front could play a factor whether it just circles around to the east coast or whether it stays to the southeast. Now, as the ensemble shows, that this one will intensify and actually get looped around by the high pressure. I will show you all the possibilities of that. But right around the 14th, we started getting anomalies popping up right above Haiti and Dominican Republic. And this is where it starts intensifying and going towards the southeast to a potential major hurricane. And as you keep going, you can see it does intensify. Matter of fact, the one right here going right towards northern Bahamas, and this is all getting suppressed down. I'll show you why. Is actually a possibility for 950 millibars, and we've been showing 960 for a while. Now, the Euro is showing that no matter what time, whether it's going to be early or later, we have a major hurricane that's going to be in this region. That's something we need to prepare for. And 10 days out, according to the Euro, this is SpaghettiOs. You can see how you got an anomaly of swooping around to the high pressure, but most of them are showing that it will carry along the Atlantic and go towards the southeast, and it will intensify according to the Euro. Matter of fact, multiple models are showing there'll be major intensification right here in the southeast. And as it go forward, you see it could go towards North Carolina, both ensembles showing a major hurricane going towards North Carolina. And it could also intensify later and still go towards the Bahamas, Florida, even come back in and loop down by southern Florida. Matter of fact, I'm showing that this is a good anomaly that it could go right over Florida. I will show you. Now, the GFS also confirms that this one will go somewhere towards the high pressure in the Atlantic, and it will circle around and intensify. But at the same time, it also confirms that we will have some cyclone formations right over the Bahamas, southeast Florida, and it will intensify also to a major hurricane. So Euro and GFS is showing this general region, we will be having a major hurricane sometime around August 14th. To August 18th. Now here's a look according to the Euro, so you can see that one big one does swing around the high pressure right here. It don't go towards northeast or the New England states. But other possibilities do go towards North Carolina. A couple ensembles, both of them showing it'll go towards North Carolina because we have our high pressure retracting back at that time. So here's the perturbed members according to the Euro, and it does show right around August 11th, we're going to get a lot of activity. We're going to have one wave that's going to be headed north. It will intensify. It will get swung around to high pressure. That's just trending like crazy. But the second wave has a good chance to either go towards the coast or go towards Florida and the Bahamas. And we have multiple perturbed members that's confirming that there will be a lot of activity towards the southeast and towards Florida and the Carolinas. This will definitely be by the 15th to the 18th on the impact. But it will be showing itself within the next few days. And when you look at cyclone locations according to the Euro and see what the possibility strength is, you can see that the one that goes towards the Carolinas can get all the way down to a 968. I think I saw 967, no 969. It can get down all the way to a 968. And the ones going towards Florida could get down to a 967. We've been seeing 960 for a while, ever since Euro showed it going by the Antilles Islands. Take a look at E8 on the perturbed members. See that it does sneak up right across Puerto Rico, and it does strengthen and intensify and head towards the Bahamas and Florida. And that is a good possibility. That is a lot of trending going on for Florida as well as the Carolinas for that outcome. If you look at Ensemble 14, you can see that it could stay weak all the way till it gets towards Florida, then just intensify and go up the coast of Florida. So that could be a possibility as well. So we do have something that is coming close. The high pressure is bringing it around, but it is intensifying at the last second. And when you look at a probability, according to the Euro, for a tropical depression, you can see that by Sunday on the 8th, we have a good chance for a tropical depression up to 80 and 85%. And you see it does travel more northern, stays close to the islands. It does get weakened by some shear, but that shear will go away for a while as it heads more to the west. When you check for a tropical storm, you can see it does have some intensity with it, according to the Euro, that it does pass by. It's not a strong chance for a tropical storm, but it will be a strong system where it'd be a weak chance for a tropical storm, a strong tropical depression. As it passes by the high pressure, gets through the shear, then the outcome is something we need to think about. Now, according to the Euro, when you look at the vorticity at 850 millibars, you can see that by the 12th, it will be hanging out right above Puerto Rico, making that westerly turn. Also, this high pressure is going to be retracting back. So I believe that the first one will be strong, and I believe it will swing around the high pressure. I don't show that that would really be an issue. That second wave, and you can see the kink right here in the lines, that as it moves towards the Caribbeans and southeast Florida, it will intensify at the last second according to all the data. So far, the Euro has it intensifying down to a 984, but you can see the path is going like a northerly pass. It's going to be swinging around this high pressure. At the same time, right when it starts swinging around, we get another wave that breaks off, and this is going to be what heads to the west. Now, the GFS also confirms that around August 12th to August 15th, that we're going to have a 980-something millibar system. Check 24-hour rainfall according to the GFS. You can see as this tropical wave travels to the west, it does have a lot of rainfall, but at the same time, we have two. We have the one up here in the north, and we have the one that's passing down here through the islands as it goes western in the Caribbean. So I do believe that the stronger one will get pulled up to the north, and this will creep along the Caribbean islands and intensify when it comes out by Cuba, somewhere by the Bahamas. You can also see with the PWAT anomaly, according to the GFS, how this does strengthen up, but it does get pulled out by this high pressure, and it does head north and start swinging around this high pressure, staying away from everybody. The intensification that happens in the southeast is from the sneaky deaky one that comes through the islands and intensifies at the last moment. This first big one so far will swing around this high pressure and be no threat. It will be strong. It will probably get named because it will be some good strength to it. I'm not showing threat from the first one yet. It will be the second one. Now, the AO, according to the Euro, shows that the next anomaly will be coming down now all the way until the 11th, and it will continue to drop into our U.S. This is the same cold front that's going to actually probably help us keep this thing away from the East Coast. Even the NAO on the Euro, the North Atlantic Oscillation, shows that this high ridge will start going away as we get closer towards the 11th. It'll start dropping lower and lower and lower. So when that cold air comes in, it'll be into the southeast of the U.S., kind of protecting it from any damage from any cyclones coming in its way. That's why it's going to take that southern push, and it can't come into the East Coast. The GFS, which shows a little bit longer, does confirm that we will have this dip come in all the way to the 11th. And it shows from the 12th all the way to the 15th and 16th, there will be another one. And this is so important. This is the cold front right around the time that we have these cyclones right off into the tropical Atlantic. And this will actually stop it from going towards the East Coast and hit it with some cold, dry air, and it will not strengthen up or hit land. So this will actually save the East Coast right here from any tropical activity. That's why I still think it's going to spread one north in Atlantic and one south towards our Caribbean. And you can see that here, right around August 14th or 15th, we have this cold, dry air coming down from our country, and we have a tropical wave that's headed to the west. And as it gets closer, the cold air comes down, it does put a block, it does hit it, and stops any formation. At this point, you have northerly winds headed to the south, so it will be a lot of shear, so if it does head that way, it would not survive. So it circles around the high pressure and gets swung out into the Atlantic Ocean. That's according to this one. And then that second piece that breaks off is a little more southern, and this is the one that heads towards the southeast. You see that you do have easterly winds pushing to the west, and the wave does take that path right around that high pressure as this high pressure circles around out here and starts retracting back. And when it retracts back, it's going to let it take that northern push. And as you see, it goes towards the west, the cold front comes in, it hits it, and makes it go north. So it looks like the cold front will be blocking this from coming on land so far. You follow the ensembles to see exactly what this high pressure is doing. And the low pressures is this yellow with the red writing. You can see how it comes forward. Then the high pressure will start retracting back as this system moves by. You see how it has all this open area now to roam. The high pressure is all retracted back. And now you can either come towards the cold front, you have this one higher, or you can have this big system right here. And this is August 13th. And as anomalies get closer, you can see as they strengthen up and head towards the southeast because that high pressure is not there. So one will swing around the high pressure while the second wave heads towards the Caribbean and the southeast. And this one actually shows that by the 16th and 17th that it could go right up Florida. And if it's a little bit later or a little bit sooner, it could curve a little more and show like the Euro's been showing, that could go towards South Carolina or North Carolina as a major hurricane. It's all about timing with this cold front coming. Whether it's going to be late in the night travel where the cold front is going to be down, or is it going to be daytime heating where that cold front is not going to be there. So it's all about timing, but so far the high pressure is going to retract back and leave all this open space to roam. Now I wanted to keep this video kind of short just so I can give you the information that we have so far of what can happen. And so far, the Euro and the GFS shows that we will have a potential major problem right off either the East Coast or off the East Coast of Florida. And it's right around the 15th to the 18th for the impact dates. But it's going to start around the 11th or 12th. So we need to keep updating this. We need to keep our eyes open on what's going on for this hurricane season. You know I am open 24 hours on this. I just wanted to keep this pretty simple, just show you the updated information that we do have according to the ensembles on all models on what's going on, not just one. And now, for the first time in a while, we have two, Euro and GFS, both showing a potential major hurricane off the southeast coast. So we need to stay up on this. It is showing this high pressure will be retracting back. Then it has all the room it needs. It could even swing around and hit towards Virginia, maybe even somewhere else. I will stay on this for you. And we're still having all this weather in the southeast and the mid-Atlantic. If you didn't see the last two videos, these two high pressures are causing some very extreme weather. So I will play this for you so you can see the next 60 hours. Same time, God bless you all. Hope you have a very blessed Monday out there. Have a great week. Start off great, start off positive. Positive things will happen. Positive thinking brings positive results, that's a fact. So I'm going to play this for you. The time and date is on the top left. It will loop around so you can see what's going on with these storms. At the same time, continuing our reading from Revelation. Today is Revelation 6. And I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals, and I heard, as it were, the noise of thunder, one of the four beasts saying, "Come and see." And I saw, and behold, a white horse. And he that sat on him had a bow, and a crown was given unto him. And he went forth conquering and to conquer. And when he had opened the second seal, I heard the second beast say, "Come and see." And there went out another horse that was red, and power was given to him that sat thereon to take peace from the earth, and that they should kill one another. And there was given unto him a great sword. And when he had opened the third seal, I heard the third beast say, Come and see. And I beheld, and lo, a black horse. And he that sat on him had a pair of balances in his hand. And I heard a voice in the midst of the four beasts say, A measure of wheat for a penny, and three measures of barley for a penny. And see thou hurt not the oil and the wine. And when he had opened the fourth seal, I heard the voice of the fourth beast say, Come and see. And I looked, and behold, a pale horse. And his name that sat on him was Death, and Hell followed with him. And power was given unto them over the fourth part of the earth, to kill with sword, and with hunger, and with death, and with the beast of the earth. And when he had opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of them that were slain for the word of God, and for the testimony which they held. And they cried with a loud voice, saying, How long, O Lord, holy and true, doest thou not judge and avenge our blood on them that dwell on the earth? And white robes were given unto every one of them, and it was said unto them that they should rest yet for a little season, until their fellow servants also, and their brethren, that should be killed as they were, should be fulfilled. And I beheld, when he had opened the sixth seal, and lo, there was a great earthquake, and the sun became black as sackcloth of hair, and the moon became as blood. And the stars of heaven fell unto the earth, even as a fig tree casteth her untimely figs, when she is shaken of a mighty wind. And the heaven departed as a scroll when it is rolled together, and every mountain and island were moved out of their places. And the kings of the earth, and the great men, and the rich men, and the chief captains, and the mighty men, and every bondman and every free man, hid themselves in the dens and in the rocks of the mountains, and said to the mountains and rocks, Fall on us, and hide us from the face of him that sitteth on a throne, and from the wrath of the Lamb. For the great day of his wrath is come, and who shall be able to stand? Amen. God bless you all. Hope you have a very great and a very blessed day today. I will keep this updated. This is something that we need to stay on day per day now, because now it's starting to ramp up. We're getting into August, and this high pressure is moving away, and that's a big threat. Thank you again for visiting my channel today. I wish you and your families the best. All glory does go to Yahweh, God of Jacob. Amen. Hallelujah, guys. Have a very, very blessed day.